Emirates Red Crescent, or ERC, helps fire victims in Iraqi refugee camp. After a fire erupted at the Sharia refugee camp in Dahuk in Iraq's Kurdistan region, the ERC sent a delegation to distribute food, clothing, medical supplies, and other necessities to help the thousands of refugees at the camp. In addition, the delegation also oversaw the carrying out of several initiatives, including supplying food boxes and presents to benefit the nearly 11,000 orphans in Kurdistan that the ERC supports on an ongoing basis. Fahad Abdulrahman bin Sultan, Deputy Secretary General for International Development and Cooperation at the ERC, emphasized the United Arab Emirates' aid to the fire victims is part of the nation's solidarity with people suffering from natural disasters and crises worldwide. Our sincere gratitude, Emirates Red Crescent and Fahad Abdulrahman bin Sultan, for your timely support. May Allah bless all the sorrowful people in Iraqi Kurdistan to live in safety, peace, and harmony.
Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, climate study calls for deep reductions in greenhouse gas emissions. A new report prepared by the IPCC Working Group 1 assesses that climate change is widespread, rapid, and intensifying, as shown by extreme weather around the globe and unprecedented climate system changes. Entitled Climate Change 2021, the Physical Science Basis, the paper warns that the global temperature is projected to reach or exceed 1.5 degrees Celsius of warming within the next 20 years and exceed 2 degrees Celsius of heating during the 21st century. Sovereignly, the United Nations Secretary General, His Excellency Antonio Guterres, said the assessment is a code red for humanity. To address the climate crisis, the publication calls for various key actions, including strong, rapid, and sustained reductions in methane emissions, which are largely released through fossil fuel use and by the animal livestock industries. The IPCC and the United Nations are shining world leadership for Life-Saving Hero Award laureates. Many thanks for the vital report, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change Working Group 1. Our deep thanks, Your Excellency Antonio Guterres, for your urgent warning to humanity. May everyone quickly embrace the vegan diet to help reduce methane emissions and thus save our planet in divine wisdom.
Leading supermarket chain helps to reduce food waste. Australia's biggest supermarket chain, Woolworths, is now selling spinach that would otherwise be sent to landfill due to not being the correct size or shape. The healthy green gift from nature was recently added to the Old Bench range, which offers less than perfect looking fruits and vegetables at prices that can be up to 40% cheaper. The spinach leaves are also sold chopped to help reduce the amount of plastic needed for the bag. The produce saving strategy has helped sell 204,000 metric tons of food that would otherwise have been wasted, in addition to giving farmers additional income. Excellent news, Woolworths, on the new addition to your Old Bench range. In the support of the Providence, may we always give gratitude for the food that we receive from the diligent farmers and loving earth.
Canadian non-governmental organization, or NGO, helps protect forests from unnecessary logging. Vancouver-based nonprofit Canopy, founded in 1999 by Nicole Raycroft, has been helping to protect virgin, valuable, and endangered forests for over 20 years. By providing auditing of supply chains and supporting the recycled or sustainable packaging solutions of partner companies, Pack for Good is one of the NGO's campaigns that has so far attracted 750 companies, including Amazon, H&M, Marks and Spencer, and more. Ms. Raycroft refers to ancient forests as the cathedrals of the natural world, and as a part of the solutions offered, Canopy connects companies with providers of alternative pulp, such as wheat and rice straw, that can be turned into packaging. Way to go, Nicole Raycroft and Canopy, on your dedicated efforts to protect the beautiful forests of the world with intelligent solutions. In divine abundance, may industry and packaging producers collaborate to create more smart solutions to help save the forests and the animals in them.
Father in France constructs robotic exoskeleton for son to walk. Robotics engineer Jean-Louis Constanza co-founded company Wondercraft, which has built an advanced suit-like mechanism to help his son Oscar walk. Oscar's legs do not work properly due to a problem with the nerves carrying signals from his brain to his legs, and the device helps him to be more independent. Wondercraft currently sells the device to hospitals around Europe and is working on a lighter version for personal use. In the future, it is expected that the technology could replace wheelchairs. Kudos, Jean-Louis Constanza and the Wondercraft team, for your remarkable robotic exoskeleton to help increase the mobility of people affected by a disability. In celestial peace, may your technology that improves people's lives bring much joy and freedom to them.
U.S. city endeavors to phase out all animal product purchases to address climate change. The City Council of Berkeley in California, USA, recently passed a resolution setting a goal to reduce the quantity of animal-based products the city purchases by half by 2024. Thus, Berkeley will begin serving vegan food at locations and events managed by the city, such as summer camps, senior centers, and the Berkeley City Jail. The measure further states the city adopts an eventual goal of a 100% shift to serving plant-based food products. The resolution authored by Berkeley City Mayor, the Honorable Jesse Ergin, and Council Member, the Honorable Sophie Hahn, comes from the efforts of a coalition of animal rights and human advocacy groups. Mayor Ergin commented on the resolution, saying, "This is a very important step for the city to take as part of our broader climate efforts, as well as promoting the humane treatment of animals." Berkeley is the first city council in the U.S. to move towards a completely plant-based food purchasing program. Our tremendous appreciation, City of Berkeley and all organizations involved, for this momentous decision. May your courageous example be followed by all cities and countries around the world to soon realize a vegan world for everyone in heaven's delight.
Scottish woman maintains friendship with bull after rescuing him as calf. Heidi Ross from Scotland, United Kingdom, formed a close friendship with Thor, an almost 750-kilogram shorthorn bull, after rescuing him as a baby around 3 years ago. Thor was born premature, was having challenges breathing, and faced being later sent to the slaughterhouse. Miss Ross implored the manager of the farm, where she works as a housekeeper, to let her buy the calf. She then raised Thor in a nearby field, and the pair became inseparable. Miss Ross said, "I believe that any animal given the chance will prove that all creatures are sentient. They have feelings and emotions, just like other animals which humans naturally befriend, like dogs, cats, and horses." Our admiration, Heidi Ross, for your kind heart to help an innocent being in need. May Thor have many joyous years ahead with his dear human friend in the divine's immense compassion.